Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, everyone. So after that introduction, I think the wrong person is sitting here. So we're going to wait for a little while to see if the right person who he just described comes in. Nice to have you all here. Nice to be with you. Thank you very much for coming. My name is Janitai Das. So we're going to speak a little bit today about Lord Chaitanya. And because on Thursday, this coming week, it is known as Gaura Purnima, which is the full moon day. And this is the anniversary of the appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in this world over 500 years ago. So we will have a big celebration, and we would like to invite all of you to come in preparation for these holy or sacred days. It's always good to cultivate our consciousness in such a way that we're remembering the personality who will be celebrated on these days, so like that. So first I'm going to sing Jai Radha Madhav. Be good if the words were up, but maybe so we can get that. But first I just wanted to say that today we're also going to play a little game. We're going to have a little lottery.
We don't gamble.
But I'm hoping today that there will be a couple of winners. Who would like to be a winner? Well, who wants to be a loser? Well, who's not raising their hand? If you don't raise your hand, you're a loser. Okay? So who wants to be a winner? In Krishna consciousness, you say you're a winner by raising both hands. And you say, Gauranga! Okay, so today's winners will be chosen at random. And there will be little sounds emitting from mobile phones. And when your mobile phone rings, we'll all know who the winner is. And the winner gets to sponsor a Veda book. And it's you can't imagine the spiritual benefit you will get. That's why you'll be a winner. And it's only £10. We've increased the price today to make you more of a winner. So I encourage everyone, please take out your mobile and put it on the loudest ringtone that you have. Okay? Because we don't want to miss being a winner, do you? Okay, everyone's got that one? All right. Maybe we could just move forward a little bit because there's lots of people coming in the back. So here in ISKCON, London, in the center of downtown, I went to see the doctor before I came today, and he said I don't have any contagious diseases, and my mental illness where I used to attack people, that's also going away now. It's good. You're safe, Peru. So please come forward. So yeah, we like to be a nice, tight-knit family here in London. So we've specifically made the room small for that purpose. Just a quick question before I begin. Is there anyone who happens to be here for the first time? Anyone here for the first time? Okay. Anyone here for the second time? Anyone for the third time? Okay. It's only my fourth time, so those of you who are here for the first time, just four more times and you can sit here. Okay, so we're going to chant this wonderful bhajan or devotional song that our spiritual teacher, Swami Prabhupada, he used to sing before he would give class. And he described that this this song is like a window into the spiritual world. And it gives us a glimpse of the activities and loving relationships that exist in the spiritual world with Krishna. So we can all join in. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava
Anjana Shalakaya Chakshuromilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Stapitam Gena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Bhati Swapadantikam Mandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Parakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sahagaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Namita Shri Vishakam Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kamchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vishavanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Turubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki So before I begin speaking, I would like to seek blessings from all of the assembled Vaishnavas that you see fit to bestow your mercy upon me so that I can speak something of the glories of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, many of us have gathered here today, probably from many different places, probably from many backgrounds and different walks of life. Probably there are easily, I would say, maybe at least 20 to 25 different countries represented in this room. And so many different languages being spoken. And as I said, so many different backgrounds, cultural uniqueness. But somehow we're all gathered here. Now, it's described in the ancient scriptures, known as the Vedas, that in the future of the world, that actually people from all different cultures and backgrounds would start to come together and merge together. Probably even 300 years ago, everyone was kind of in their own little pockets, right? So this community would be here and that community there. But now we have these huge cities that have grown up. And in the cities, people from all over the world come together, right? In your workplace, in your schools, maybe even in your little towns, right? There are people from all over the world, isn't it? And the thing is that generally when so many people from different cultures come together, usually there's a lot of differences in opinions, isn't it? And usually the focus is on that. And when the focus is on these differences, then generally there's disagreement and there's arguing. Right, angles of perspective, misunderstanding, right? Anyone has this experience? So it's described that the age that we're living in now is known as Kali Yuga. And in this age, it's epitomized by the characteristics of quarrel, confusion, and hypocrisy. Has anyone seen these attributes and qualities around? So we see it in the world around us all the time. Simply you have to open the newspaper or turn on the television. Maybe even just look out your front window. So we see this predominating the society and the world that we live in. But if we turn that perspective inwards, do we also find inner quarrel? Yes? Do we also find confusion within our own hearts? What about hypocrisy? Do we find even hypocrisy within ourselves? So it's described that if we want to make a difference in the world around us, first we have to start to make a difference to the world within us. So the change has to start here. And it's easy to pull out this magic finger, which is known as the Ahankara finger, the finger of false ego and false pride. You know this finger, right? It's the one that comes out when you want to blame someone, when you want to redistribute the cause of my distress or anxiety. But if we, our spiritual teacher explained to us that when you point one finger at someone else, you have to be very careful because there's always three fingers pointing back at you. So before we put the blame on the world and the blame on society, we should first look at ourselves. It's easy to blame others. It's not so easy to look at ourselves, isn't it? And especially when so many people from so many different cultures are coming together. They say New York is the, what do they call it? The melting pot, right? The melting pot of culture. But sometimes it seems like a recipe for disaster. But we're all here together. How can that be? Our external appearances are so different. So many varieties of colors of flesh. The skin, isn't it? How many different varieties? How many wars are waged? How many disagreements over the color of someone's flesh? Isn't it? Or the religious belief that you choose to practice. Or the language that you speak. All of these differences somehow causing so many problems. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he appeared 500 years ago to reconcile all differences. He appeared simply for the purpose of uniting everyone. Because it was understood that the world, as Kali Yuga progresses, is going to become a place that is hardly habitable for a human being. In fact, it will become inhabitable for human beings. Some of the things that are described that will happen in Kali Yuga are very difficult to repeat, because it fills you with fear of what human beings, or so-called human beings, can do with this planet. But we see it happening now, don't we? It's not as if it's something that's going to occur in the future. We see the resources of this world are being exploited. The people of this world are being exploited. It's all happening now. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission was to unite everyone, to gather everyone together under a common cause. And that cause is the glorification of God, the glorification of the Lord. And he gave a simple way of doing that, that anyone can do, anyone from anywhere, and that's simply to chant this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
You don't have to be from India. You don't have to be a Hindu. You don't have to be anything but a spiritual being. We have a winner. Who is the winner? Please raise your hand, both hands, and say, Gauranga. Who is it? I heard the phone from over here. Oh, and look, it's a confirmation. Who is it? Was it you at the back? Please turn your mobile phones up. No one's professing to be the winner. So, all we have to be is spiritual beings. That's two times a winner. And who of us here is not a spiritual being? Is there anyone? Anyone here who's not a spiritual being? So we're all related. We're all here. We all have the same source, despite the color of our skin, despite the nation of our birth, despite the sex of our body, despite the football team that we support, or the bands that we listen to. Despite all of these things, we're all already connected as spiritual entities, as spiritual beings. And why are you here? I ask you, why are you here sitting in this room? Maybe some of you are saying, we're waiting for you to be quiet so we can eat. Maybe someone took a wrong turn on Oxford Street. But probably you're here because you're seeking something. Who's looking for something? Who feels like they found something? That's why they're here. What are you looking for? Prabhu, what have you found?
Well, happiness.
Happiness. Who's looking for happiness? Who's looking for distress? Who's not raising their hand no matter what I say? The nature of the spirit soul is ananda mayobhyasat, and that means that the soul is seeking happiness, pleasure, ananda, bliss, not even just happiness, not even pleasure, but bliss, complete bliss. Who's looking for bliss? If you want bliss, put both hands up and say, Gauranga! It looks looks like you came to the right place. The process of Krishna consciousness given to us by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so simple, and it is the fundamental and basic principles that underlies everything. It helps us to understand that despite the different colors of our skin, we're all brothers and sisters. And we're all together, whether we like it or not, on this little ball floating around in space called the Earth. We're all here together anyway, whether we like it or not. And the beautiful thing about Krishna or God is that he's given all of us a minute amount of free will. Everyone understands what that means? It means we've all got the right to choose, isn't it? So you've all come here today, and I assume at least the large percentage of you have chosen to come here. Is there anyone who was forced to come here today? I mean, it is possible if mothers and fathers brought their children. I know when I was young, and my parents used to force me to go to church. And I really wanted to be playing outside somewhere. But probably we all made the choice to be here. And every day in our lives, we have the capacity to make choices. From the moment that we wake up in the morning, the opportunities start. As soon as you wake up, you have the opportunity to make a choice. And that choice leads you to a destination that enables you to make another choice. And that's life. It's a series of choices, all based on a tiny, minute amount of free will that's been given to us by Krishna, by God. Now, the fundamental choice, or let's say what we would consider the most important choice that we have to make, is what are we going to do with this life? Now, this is a question that I know many people ask in their teenage years. And then by the time you finish high school and university, you think, I just need to get on with it. There's no point in asking these silly questions because maybe there's no real answer to what is the goal of life, what is the point of life. But the irony is that question burns inside of us, isn't it? Inside, even though we're trying to forget it, often we're wondering, what am I doing here? What is the point of this life? Has anyone ever asked themselves this question? Not so many, huh? Who would like to know? What is the goal of life? Who already knows? What is the answer? Please tell us.
You're here for a purpose, and I feel inside that there are certain things in this world which is wrong, and I would have to do as much as I can to make things right, mm-hmm. in whatever ways I can. Yeah. You don't know how you're going to do it, but you have to believe you have to do it, mm-hmm. and the way it's going to come to you.
So the goal is to do the right things. Is that what you're saying? Thank you. Anyone else would like to share what they've understood to be the goal of life?
It would be happiness for me.
Happiness, to find happiness. Yeah, we discussed that so much. Yes, ma'am.
I would like to please Krishna by my actions.
You would like to please Krishna, God, by your actions. Very nice. Seems it's all the ladies today. The gentlemen are like, oh, they're just, they're nervous. They're being humble. They're allowing the ladies to go first. Yes, Mataji, what is the goal?
To communicate
to communicate our consciousness to Him, meaning the Supreme Him, Krishna, God. Okay, very nice, thank you. Anyone else? Yes. The goal is silence. Okay? That's one of the qualities of a devotee. Yes, Andrew. To love and serve Krishna. Who's Krishna?
Our Father.
Our Father. Who art in heaven. How would be thy name? Say it again. Yes. Very nice. Someone else had their hand raised? Yes.
Transcendent human form and the misery and suffering of this world.
To transcend the human form, which means all the miseries and sufferings of this world. Very nice. Yes, Prabhu.
Self-realization.
Self-realization is the goal. So it seems like there's a lot of answers, a lot of possibilities. And with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has explained that the goal of this life is to love and serve God, the Supreme, with all of our hearts. And this is explained by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, where he says, Aham sarvasya prabhavo mata sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajanti mam buddha bhava samam vitaha. Krishna says that I am the source of this material world. I am the source of the spiritual world. I am the source of everything. And the wise who perfectly know this, they engage in my devotional service and they worship me with all of their hearts. So what we want to do is become wise and understand that the goal of our life is actually to develop a relationship with the Supreme. And when we do that, we become self-realized. When we do that, we transcend the material world and all of the distresses and anxieties. When we do that, we're doing the right thing because it's watering the root of the tree and all other things that are meant to be done will happen automatically. When we do that, there may also be silence. Finally, silence within the mind. Anyone here has a mind? Anyone here has one of those minds that doesn't stop? Is it? No one. God. You're all self-realized. This is definitely a preaching to the choir class. Be honest. Who here has one of those minds that's like da 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 da? Who would like to transcend that mind? So Krishna consciousness gives us that opportunity. Because Krishna consciousness and the practice of bhakti yoga is a process which will enable us to actually find the deepest levels of peace and, as someone said, happiness. And will allow us to convey our consciousness and purify our consciousness in a way that we can communicate and speak with the Supreme, with Krishna. In fact, Srila Prabhupada said that if you take to this process seriously, you will be able to see God face to face. What a bold statement. But it's true. It's a fact. It's possible. In fact, all you have to do is turn your head that way and you can see God face to face. But do we have the eyes to see? Has our consciousness become clear enough to focus and to understand and see this? If Krishna, if God is the source of all spiritual and material worlds, then he also describes that he has entered into every atom of the material energy. So that means that God is present everywhere, in everything, at all times. Is that true? So that means at any moment, you could be completely in realization and perceiving God everywhere, in everything. True? False? Because everything is composed of his energy. And he says he is personally present there in everything. So this example is given that just like a mother has a child, and she doesn't need to personally see the child, but if she sees the small shoes of the child, she immediately remembers the child and is completely present to the child's. Does that make sense? To the child is like being is there, just in that overwhelming power and memory. So if our consciousness is fine-tuned to understand that Krishna, that everything around me is Krishna's energy. Everything is Krishna's energy. Everything is Krishna's energy. This body, comprised of the five elements, is Krishna's energy. Within the heart of every living being, Krishna is present. When I look into the eyes of this person who's encased in Krishna's energy, within there's a soul, there's a spiritual being. And beside that spiritual being is Krishna, our best friend. Suridam Sarvabhutanam, the best friend of all living entities. Krishna loves us so much that even though we decide to enter into this material world and forget his spiritual energy, he comes with us as our eternal partner and friend. He moves from body to body to body, always there with us, constantly requesting us, please seek the answers to the questions, what is the goal of life? Please seek out answers to these important questions. Please look to me. Please look for me. When we look into the eyes of another living entity, we should understand that Krishna is residing within the heart of that living being. He is present there. This person is a part and parcel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This person is my brother. This person is my sister. We should have such a deep level of respect. This is how we see God in everything. everywhere at all times. We have to deeply cultivate this consciousness. This is Krishna consciousness. And it's so simple. It's the philosophy, it's the Dharma that unites us all. The beauty in distinction, unity in diversity. But still, we're all from the same place, from the same source. But yet, we're all such beautiful, independent sparks of God's eternal splendor. Why not celebrate that? What do you think? But our nature is to be forgetful. We forget so easily. Who here has problems remembering? Probably you've already forgotten everything I've said. So we have to constantly remind ourselves. And the best way to remind ourselves first that I'm a spirit soul is to chant. Why do we chant? Why did Lord Chaitanya ask us to chant this mantra? Because the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is pure transcendental sound vibration. It's coming from the transcendental platform, from the spiritual realm. It's from the same origin as we are. And when we chant it, us, the soul, not us, the forgetful body, but us, the soul, the fully cognizant soul, hears that name, feels that sound vibration permeating throughout, and begins to awaken. And our dormant consciousness of who we are eternally begins to wake up. And we begin to remember, like someone who's been in amnesia for so long begins to see things as they really are. And this is the power of the holy name. This is the power of the Maha Mantra, that it can wake us up. Because we like to sleep, don't we? Who likes to sleep? At least two alarm clocks, right? And we probably think the snooze button was the best invention. Just five more minutes. Right? But we need to wake up. We should come to a practice in our lives that we wake up before the alarm clock. And we say, ha ha! Gotcha. I'm awake. And I'm happy to be awake. Because I have a purpose in my life. And my purpose is to constantly remember who I am and to act in that role. To act as a servant of Krishna. To chant Krishna's holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And in this consciousness, it doesn't matter what happens. You see, we live life teetering on the edge. whether we think so or not. No matter how secure your job, no matter how much money, no matter how beautiful your husband or wife, no matter your intellectual standard, you could be PhD, double PhD, triple PhD, still, your life is teetering on the edge. Why? Because at any moment, what could happen? Death. I don't know why they removed the picture, but there was a picture here this morning beside the Srila Prabhupada's altar of one very wonderful lady. Her name is Tadmihi Radha Mataji. And just yesterday, she was leaving Mayapur Dham in India, Navadweep, and she arrived in Calcutta, planning to catch a plane. And she became a little sick, and then she suffered kidney failure, and within a matter of moments, she was no longer here. Did she expect it? No. When she booked her ticket, did she think, this will be the last trip I take? No. You see, we don't know. And no matter how much we know, we still don't know. Was she prepared for that journey? Absolutely. So when it came, she wasn't bothered. Like Dhruva Maharaj in the Bhagavatam. Big Brother's watching. She just stepped on the head of death and took passage back to the spiritual world. Because this process is preparing us for the inevitable, the thing that most people are hiding from, which is the fact that this body will cease to be. And I do not know when it will cease to be. When I came into this world, they gave me a certificate. It's known as a birth certificate. And they put a stamp on it. Date of arrival. And you're welcomed into the material world. Not with a handshake, but with a smack on the backside. Welcome to the material world. And your first words are, ah! And the process of life from that moment is a continuation of that same experience. And there's a line on the other side of this certificate. And it's the date of departure. And they left it blank. And our whole lives are lived wondering, when is it? And we keep trying to forget. But it's burning inside of us. And we don't know. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he recommends we prepare. And we don't wait for tomorrow. We pack our bags now. And you carry it with you everywhere you go. This is your traveling bag right here. It's got everything you need. It's the passport to the spiritual world. So pack your bags. We're all going for a long journey. I don't know when you're leaving, and I don't know when I'm leaving, but I damn well want to be ready to go when the time comes. So that means I better get ready. What do you think? If you want to get ready, raise both your hands and say, "Go Lunga!
Go
Lunga!
Go
Lunga!" Hare Krishna. Thank you very much for your kind attention. How do you go? So, now we're going to do what everyone is actually waiting for us to do, which is eat. Of course, we don't eat here. Eating in the Hare Krishna temple isn't normal. Not only because you sit on the floor and eat with your hands, but because eating is yoga. So when we eat in the Hare Krishna temple, it's actually known as worship. Eating is known as honoring the Lord in his form as prasad or food. And it's a very sacred act, in fact. And Srila Prabhupada explained that it is a path of spiritual perfection. So even if you just come here every Sunday to eat, no problem. Because Prabhupada explained you could eat your way back to Godhead. So now we're going to honor prasadam. But first I would like to ask, there were some people here for the first time? Okay. Yeah. Sorry, what's your name? Kamil. And where are you from, Kamil?
Poland.
From Poland. Cześć, cześć. Jak się masz? Nice to have you with us. How did you find out about the temple?
From a leaflet.
From a leaflet. Where did you get the leaflet?
In
Oxford. Oxford Street. On the floor, you found it?
From one of you guys.
Some strange guy with a bald head? Or was it a strange lady without a bald head? Okay. Well, we know what kind of person you are, that when you get a leaflet from a strange guy with a bald head, you go, Camille, thank you for coming. Nice. Someone else is, you raise your hand? Okay.
I'm actually coming from Radha-Gopina.
You're here in Holland Park. What is your name?
Kumar Rabbit.
You're Kumar Rabbit. I've read thousands of emails about you, Kumar Rabbit. Nice to see you. Hare Krishna. Welcome. What's your name?
I'm Jones. I'm just from South
Wales. Woking?
Yes.
Oh my God. Did you know he's from Woking? Did you invite him?
Yeah.
Okay. You know Ajay?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. You're really lucky.
He's good luck.
He's good luck, yeah. Thank you for coming. Your name again?
Giles.
Nice to have you with us, Giles. Hare Krishna. Someone else who's here for the first time? Yes, Mataji at the back. What's your name?
My name is Krishna.
I told you could see Krishna face to face. Where are you from, Krishna?
Luton.
From Krishna from Luton. My Lord. And how did you find out about the temple?
I knew about this temple, but I couldn't make it on my way. I asked my daughter if she could bring it, and she brought me today.
Wow. Where is your daughter?
Yeah.
Hello, daughter. Thank you for bringing Krishna to all of us. Wonderful. You came all the way from Luton. Thank you. Most people from Luton go to Watford Manor.
Yes, yes.
But we're happy you came here.
I'm also very lucky
Thank you very much, Krishna, Hare Krishna. And someone else, you raise your hand. What's your name? Krishna Madhusudan. Giles. Where are you from, Madhusudan? From Glastonbury. Your parents are devotees? What's his name? Rory. Okay. So what made you decide to come today? Madhusudan? Oh, really? Amazing. Okay. Hari Bol. Ladies side, anyone here for the first time? Oh, you're a very active participant for a first time. What's your name?
Laboni.
Laboni. Yeah. And where are you from?
I'm from India.
You're from India. Where in India?
Calcutta.
Calcutta.
Yeah.
Okay. You made it out alive. And how did you find out about the temple?
Well, we happened to see it one time, and then my friend, she said that her parents are...
Okay.
So we go on
the study. Fantastic. So now you're working here in London?
Studying.
Studying. Where?
University of Westminster.
Which location?
Harrow.
In Harrow.
We live here, but
we live in Baker Street. But yes.
You live in Baker Street? Oh, you can come every day. Okay, very nice. Thank you for coming. Anyone else? It's not your first time, I know. Okay, please let us express our gratitude and appreciation for all these souls who came for the first time by raising our hands and chanting very loudly three Hari Bols.
Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Hari Bol!
And who's greeting guests today? Karuna Mayi Mataji, you can come in for one moment. So those of you who are here for the first time, you can go and speak to Karuna Mayi, who's waving her hand right now. So she has a gift for everyone who's come for the first time. So please go and speak to her. And anyone who would like to give her your email address or contact details so we can let you know when festivals and different guest speakers and different things are happening here in the temple, then she'll be happy to take that information from you also. So please speak with her. Okay, it's been a great honor and privilege to be here with all of you today. I beg you all, please come on Thursday for Gaur Purnim for the celebrations of the appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I will have His Holiness Atmanaveda Namaraj. We'll have His Holiness Atmanaveda Namaraj with us in the morning, and His Grace Rupa Bilas Prabhu in the evening. And we'll have Harinam Sankirtan procession at 1 o'clock, where we'll go down Oxford Street with the big cart, lots of chanting and dancing in the streets. And we'll have a feast in the evening, bhajans and kirtan, abhishek, dramas, so much festivities. So please come and join us here in the temple on Thursday, whatever time you can make it. You're welcome to come. We'll start at 4:30 a.m. with or without you. And you can join any time after that. Jai Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki
jai.
Okay, so now we'll say the prayer before taking prasadam. And after we finish, we ask those persons who've come for the first time, if you can please sit along the wall here. If everyone can please make some space for them. We'll have some other devotees who are here to answer any questions that you have. Sundanatakuru will be doing questions and answers upstairs from about 6 o'clock. He'll be there to happily answer your questions. And then we'll have kirtan at 7 after we finish prasadam for the Gaur Aarti. And then we'll have a drama at 7:30. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki. So now we'll say the prasadam prayer. If you know it, please join in. If you don't, you can meditate on the transcendental sound vibration. Mahaprasade Govinde, Nama Brahmani Vaishnave, Swapapanya Vatan Raja, Vishwashona Vijayate, Ekadasi Vata Ki Jai. So today is Ekadasi, that means we're fasting from grains. So like that, special feast today. Hare Krishna. Shiva Prabhupada Ki Jai.